Hey, what is up, people? Gold Izzy back at you with another video. Big match has been signed for WrestleMania 28. I know. WrestleMania 27 just happened, and we already have a main event match signed for WrestleMania 28, a year away. A lot of people giving their thoughts and opinions on this, and if you don't know what I'm talking about, I'll go ahead and tell you. John Cena called out The Rock this past Monday night on Raw for the events that happened on WrestleMania 27 the night before, and basically when it was all said and done, we had a match. So we're gonna see John Cena versus The Rock at WrestleMania 28. It's great to see that we will see this match. Okay, that's the great part. The bad part is that it's a year away. I mean, when they made that announcement, the crowd was booing. They were not happy whatsoever with that announcement. Don't get me wrong, they were happy with the fact that they were going to see The Rock versus John Cena. That's the great part. But man, to have to wait another year to see the smash, that's just kind of a downer. Especially when you look at the fact that the WWE, you know, has been kind of teasing us with a possible John Cena versus The Rock match. You know, they had all those weeks of build with them bickering at one another each week, and basically they did all that just so The Rock would interfere in John Cena's match at WrestleMania and cost him the WWE Championship. I mean, that's great. I'm glad all that happened, but man, I really don't want to have to wait another year to see this match. I mean, it's something that has been building for years. You know, John Cena made those comments several years ago, and The Rock, of course, and John Cena, you know, we all want to see that. We want to see it. We just don't want to wait another year. I'm happy it's been signed. I just wish it wasn't another year away. I wish we could speed up time a little bit, if you know what I mean. But, okay, I mean, so yeah, we have a match that has been signed for WrestleMania 28. Okay, maybe the match hasn't been officially signed, but it has been announced. So, what on earth is the WWE going to do now with a match that has been announced at WrestleMania 28? And they've got a year-long gap before the match. How are they going to handle this? Are we going to see some storyline with this for the next year? Are they going to kind of just forget about the match for a while and not bring it back up until, like, what, January again? Like they do with most WrestleMania matches? I mean, what are they going to do? I would kind of like to see if maybe the WWE can stretch out a full year-long storyline. I mean, that's the kind of thing that you saw a lot in the old days of wrestling. You always used to see year-long storylines and stuff like that. But in this day and age, you just don't see that kind of thing anymore. But it would be interesting to see the WWE. But it would be interesting to see the WWE try to pull off a year-long storyline. I think that would be fantastic, especially if they can make it work. And I think if they did it right, they can make it work with The Rock and John Cena. Those are two high-profile wrestlers, and you know, that's definitely something that the people would be very interested in watching each week on Raw. So there, we have that. But now we have another tough question. Who on earth should win this match at WrestleMania 28? Should The Rock win? Should John Cena win? You have, you know, a number one guy in the Attitude Era going up against the number one guy of today's generation. So who should win this match? You know, that's a tough question. I myself would probably pick The Rock as the winner simply because, you know, he is The Rock. He has done a lot for the business. Not to say that John Cena hasn't done a lot for the business, because he has, but let's face it, you know, The Rock has brought in a lot more ratings than John Cena would ever dream about doing. And I'm not saying that John Cena doesn't deserve a good win, but let's face it, John Cena has been on top of the WWE ladder for the last several years. He has had many WrestleMania wins, and he doesn't need another win. I mean, The Rock, yeah, he's been gone for 7 years. A lot of people have their opinion on The Rock. I know I do. But The Rock, ever since coming back to the WWE, has kind of rekindled a flame that has been missing in the WWE. And oh man, it's just been exciting for the last several weeks to see The Rock back. So, you know, anyways, it doesn't really matter who wins the match, just as long as it's something that's awesome, something that's great. And if they're able to really do well with the storyline, you know, a full year before the match is crazy to think about. But if they can really, if they can pull it off with a great storyline, you know, continue to build on it throughout the rest of the year and produce a great match, then I really don't care who wins, because that's all that matters, really. But yeah, I would probably have to put my money on The Rock, no doubt. But yeah, I thought that was very interesting, to say the least. I don't think the WWE has ever done that before. I don't think they have ever signed a WrestleMania match a year in advance. I don't think I could ever remember them ever doing that. But whatever, that's it for now. Give me your thoughts and opinions on John Cena versus The Rock at WrestleMania 28. Big, big news. I would love to hear what you guys have to say about the matter. So let me know what you think in the comments below. This is Gold Izzy. Peace out.